Hello everyone, this is Richard G, and today we're going to be doing another dungeon. Today we are going to be going to Happiness Lake. This is another dungeon that's actually very close to town. In fact, it's just to the right of Sunny Hillside. But if you go from town, this is an easier way to get to it. Just follow the path. All right, let's go in. Happiness Lake is 7 floors in length. There are no bosses, and there is a end box. This place is primarily for water types, as you can see. Now, what I'm using now is my HM user. So, there's a couple Pokemon that are exclusive to this place. For example, you're seeing Yanma, and there's Lotad. Another exclusive Pokemon here is actually Magikarp. It's only on floors 6 and 7. It can be used for early on if you don't have a water type, so let's go for it. Alright. As you can see, there's a lot of water. If you have a flying water or ghost type or something that can levitate, you can walk on the water. So just a tip there. Not much for items as you're seeing, but mostly poke is what we're finding, which is typical. That's normal for dungeons. This is one of the only places to get Yanma, so if you're hoping for a Yanmega, good place to get it. Same if you want a Gyarados, this is the only place you can get Magikarp. Now, as I was showing you with my Zigzagoon, it really wasn't doing too well in here. That low of level is not going to work in this dungeon. I think we just went in a circle. So let's go down here. Yep, there's the stairs. This place can be a little tough to navigate if you can't walk on the water. Also, when it's raining, watch out for these water types. They can deal more damage. Alright, and right on 6F, there's a Magikarp right there. And as you can see, it's a little darker in here. Something about the water, if you walk on it. On these floors, 6 and 7, you may find Reviver Seeds in the water, as well as Geopebble and, for some reason, Slip Seeds. Okay, in the corner there, you might have seen the Geopebble. Reviver Seeds are a bit rare, so don't expect to see them all the time, but if we do, it's gonna be nice. It's the first dungeon you can actually find Reviver Seeds inside, so it does have some potential. As you can see, at this point it gets a little more complex with the water. So having a water type does help to get through here, especially water if you're early on, but that's all I can say about that. You just gotta hope you can walk on it to navigate. I'm just kinda looking through. Alright, now for the final floor, I'm gonna be using my Hydreigon because it levitates. First off, in the middle we have our box. Now on the outside, we have poke, either piles of 5 or 10. Adding up, it is a total of 85 poke. So, it's free money if you can go through the water. And it's all the way around. And that's all of it. If you actually got a calculator and add that up, it's always 85 poke. Alright. That's Happiness Lake right there. and we are out. All right, so that was Happiness Lake. It can prove difficult if you're not prepared. It definitely helps to have something to walk on water, though. If you don't, you could still do it. It's just a little harder to navigate. As for the darkness, if you're a new player, there's nothing you can really do about that. But it ain't that terrible. But that was Happiness Lake. Now, I should add with the box. The items included are as follows. Max Ether, Last Seed, Soft Sand, Honey, 10 Geopebble, Big Apple. There are Reviver Seeds in there. Poison Barb, Lumberry, and Mystic Water. So, there's some good stuff in the boxes for newer players. Definitely the Reviver Seed, that's good. Honey is nice to get. As for Soft Sand and Mystic Water, if you have Pokemon of respective types of either ground or water with moves, powers up the moves when held. So, there's some good stuff for you newer players. But anyway, that is Happiness Lake. And I think that's it. So, this has been Richard G, and I will see you next time.